In this video, I'm answering the question, what Bible translation is the most accurate so you can make a better choice of what translation you want to use. Let's get right into it. Hey, ihr Lieben, welcome to this video, welcome to this channel. I'm Yeshuah, yeshuahboyton.com, trying to help you grow in faith, experience the gospel, and walk it out daily. So if you're up for that kind of content, please consider subscribing and be part of this community, be part of this tribe where we encourage each other and grow together in faith, experience the gospel together, and walk it out together. Now the big question, what Bible translation should you use? Now to answer this question in full, I have to give you a little bit of context and a little bit of background. And at the very end, I will tell you what Bibles I use and I would recommend for you to use as well. Now, first of all, the context. For that, we have to talk about the original text. The original text in the Old Testament, as you may know, is written in Hebrew and in Aramaic. The New Testament is written in the Old Greek. About the manuscripts in the Old Testament, there's not much of a question because they were preserved very well. They were kept in dry and sandy areas, so they were not very damaged. Also, the copiers back then, when they were copying the manuscripts, they would give value to the little dots and letters and whatnot. They would all add it up at the end of the line, would add it up at the end of the page, and if it wouldn't come out to the right value, they would just burn the page and start over with the copying process. So the authenticity about the Old Testament manuscripts is actually not very questionable. With the New Testament manuscripts, though, it is a little bit different. With the New Testament manuscripts, we have over 25,000 fragments. That's a lot. But the reason is basically the persecution in the early church. To not get discovered and caught and not to have the manuscripts being burned and taken away, they would cut them in little pieces and would divide the little verses among each other so that when they would come back together, they all would have that one manuscript piece. Additionally to that, you have to remember that the New Testament was mostly written or kept and shared in the European and European Asian region. That means back then especially it was more wet, it was more moldy, they had to renew their copies and their manuscripts more often, which makes it all a little bit harder to identify which one is more accurate and more authentic. Now if you take all those manuscripts in the New Testament together, you end up with 250 pages of Greek text. With the original Old Greek text and the New Testament, we basically have two main directions where they come from. On the one hand, we have the Western manuscripts with the Textus Receptus, and on the other hand, we have the Eastern texts manuscripts with the more critical texts. The difference in those two versions is basically just half a page. There's no difference in any doctrine or any doctrine being taken away. It's actually just in the spelling of some of the words. So summed up, the whole difference makes up just one half of a page out of the 250 pages. As translation examples, we have the King James Bible that is based on the Western manuscripts, which has, I believe, the 250 pages that it is based upon. And then you have on the other side with the more critical texts, the minority of the text, which is half a page less, you have the NIV that is based upon those manuscripts. So if the difference is just half a page and it's basically just spellings or spelling mistakes even, what Bible translation is now the most accurate? That's point number two. For that, we have to go into the three different styles of translation. The first style is the interlinear translation, which means a word for word translation, which means one word in Greek is translated in one word in English, another word in Greek, another word in English, and it's word for word for word for word. Interlinear and very literal translation. A good example for that is the NASB, the New American Standard Bible. Now the second style of translation is the thought-for-thought translation, where the translators basically take the thought out of the verse and translate the thought into the English. A good example for that would be the NIV. The third and last translation style is the style of paraphrasing, where they paraphrase sections of the Bible or verses of the Bible in the original text and paraphrase it and reword it into the English. A good example for that would be the Message Bible. Of course, the pros for the thought-for-thought and the paraphrasing translation style is, of course, that the reading and the wording is better understandable, easier to understand, especially for people like me as a non-English major speaker. As you hear, it's easier to understand. And maybe even for people that are new in faith that have trouble with reading the traditional King James Version with all the these and thous. That brings me to my third and last point in this video, which is what translations I use and which translations I would recommend for you. The Bible translations that I use for my personal devotions and for my Bible studies when I prepare for sermons are the King James Version, or rather likely the New King James Version. I use those two usually as the text to preach on or to read out when I preach, because most of the people that I preach to are using the King James, and so that they understand the text better, it's in like a newer, better understandable English, I use the New King James Version. That's my first choice and my first recommendation to you. The second would be the ESV, which is a little bit more in the interlinear translation style. It's though better understandable. I would say sometimes even better understandable than the NASB. I do not own the last one, but I do read in it on my phone, for example, and on the computer if I want to study and go deeper in the text. Those two would be my second recommendation for you. Now my third choice and my third recommendation would be the Amplified Bible. Now with this one, you have to know that it's a little harder to just read for just the reading's sake. I would encourage you to get this if you want to dive deeper into meanings of words. Here though, you have to be a little bit careful, because I believe sometimes they just give you the meaning of some English words, not necessarily of the Greek or the Hebrew words. If you want to dive deep into the original texts, let me know in the comments section below if you want another video about how to study the Bible in the original. If you want some tools about how to study the Bible, then I will make another video about that. And my recommendation as well, of course you can get it to study, but if you want to go in the original text, go online, seek some original text in the Greek and the Hebrew, look up the words, and it will give you a better understanding and a deeper meaning. Now my last and final recommendation and Bible translation that I use is the Spurgeon Study Bible, the Christian Standard Bible, which is pretty cool. It's very easy to read. It has notes of Spurgeon, his sermon notes and study notes that he put in between, and in his Bible it has some study notes on the bottom, which is very helpful. I like it very much to read, to just read it and go through it. Sometimes it's helpful in studying some certain scriptures and some certain topics. So this will be my fourth recommendation. All those recommendations, all those Bibles are listed below. I linked them with an affiliate link, so if you consider buying one of those Bibles or even another product through those links, it really would benefit this channel. At the end, it really depends on you. I hope this video helped you to make a better decision, but you have to decide. Do you want a Bible that is more interlinear, more true to the original text, or do you want a Bible that you can understand better, that has a simpler and better understandable English? I hope this video was helpful to you and was a blessing. If so, share this video, but also the gospel, with a friend. See you in the next one. Bye.